We can use another method as well, that is directly division. So 23 upon 100. So 23 doesn't come in table of 100. So what we will do is 100 ones are, 100 zeros are, and I'll add a decimal point over here. Okay, so that the number becomes 230. So 100 ones are 100, 100 twos are 200. So how much remains? 30. Okay, as I have added a decimal point over here, I can add one more zero over here. So 100 ones are 100, 100 twos are 200, and 100 threes are 300. So this is my answer, 0.23. Let us see another example, that is 35.6%. So 35.6%, I'll write 35.6 divided by 100. So I have to remove the decimal point from here. So what will I do? I will count the digit, number of digits present after the decimal point. So I have only one digit over here, that is 6. So what I'll do is 356, as it is, I'll write without the decimal point. And I will add 10, as in the numerator we have only one digit after the decimal point. And now we will solve this. As we solve this, we'll get our answer 6530. In this manner, we can solve the rest of the questions. Let us see question number 3. Convert each of the following fraction into a percentage. First one, 23 upon 100. Here we have one rule, that is converting a fraction or a percentage into a percentage. To convert a fraction or a decimal into a percentage, we multiply it by 100. So let us see one example. 9 upon 25. So what we will do over here, we will write the number as it is and we will multiply it by 100 according to the rule. Okay, multiply by 100. After we solve this, we will get our answer 36%. In such a manner, we will try to solve this question. Question number 3 in that A1, 23 upon 100. So 23 upon 100 multiplied by 100, because the rule says for the conversion that we have to multiply the given number into 100. 100 ones are 100 ones are. So the answer comes 23%. So question number 3, 23 by 100. Let us see another example. We'll see n. Okay? Because the question is given in the form of mixed fraction. So, first step will be to convert the mixed fraction into a proper fraction. So, how we will do? We saw that before also. We'll see it again. So, 2 into 5 plus 1. That is the numerator and the denominator as it is. As we solve, we'll get 5 twos are 10 plus 1 upon 5 as it is. 10 plus 1 becomes 11 upon 5 and multiply by 100, which gives us 220. So 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 0, 11 multiply by 20 will give you 220%. In this manner, we can solve the rest of the questions. Now, let us see question number 4. Convert each of the following decimals into percentage. So, in that we'll see A1, 0.8. So, 0.8 multiplied by 100, because this is the rule. We have learnt about it earlier. And 0.8 multiplied by 100, percent is mentioned over there. So, what we will do over here is 8 upon 10 multiplied by 100. So, from where did the 10 came? Now, 10, as we know that there is one digit after the decimal point. So, to remove that one digit, I have added 10 in the denominator. So, when there is nothing in the denominator, means there is 1. So, 0.1 upon, 0.8 upon 1. Okay, there was nothing. but it means there is one in the denominator. So this will become 8 upon 10 after we remove the decimal point. So 8 upon 10 multiplied by 100. 10 ones are 10, 10s are 100. 8 into 10 is equals to 80%. Same method we will follow for the rest of the questions. Here in second one, we have 2 digits after the decimal point. Therefore, we will convert 25 upon 100, 2 zeros, 1 and second one. Because there are 2 digits after a decimal point. So 25 upon 100 multiplied by 100%, okay, that will give you 25. 100 will get cancelled, 25 as it is. Let us see question number 5. Find the value of 24% of 175. So 24% of 175 means 24 upon 100, because percentage sign is mentioned over there. So 24% means what? 24 upon 100 of 175 multiply by 175. After we solve the whole equation, we'll get our answer. Now, for the remaining question also, we'll follow the same method. 8%. 8% means what? 8 upon 100 multiply by 2 to 5. Okay. 5 2s are 10, 0. 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. 5 4s are 20, 5 9s are 45. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 2 9s are 18. 18 is your answer. Okay. Let us see question number 6. Find the value of 20% of 70%. This also we will solve in the same manner like how we solved question number 5. So 20% of 70 rupees. So 20 upon 100 and 70 rupees. Okay. 0, 0 will cancel. 7 2s are 14. So this is the answer. Let's see second one. 70% of 40 kgs. So 70 upon 100 multiply by 40 kgs. Okay. After solving, you'll get your answer 28 kgs. Now, let us see a different type of question now. E1. Okay. 60% of a year. So what we have done over here is we have converted 1 year into days. So we know that 1 year consists of 365 days. So I have written over here 60 upon 100, as you can see, multiply by 365. That is our days. And after solving, we get the answer 219 days. Now you can either write it in days or you can write it in months. Let us see another type. 5% of a meter. Now we know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So we will convert 5 upon 100 as it is 5%, and 1 meter. 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So 100 over here. 100 will get cancelled. Your answer will be 5 centimeter. Next we have 8% of a liter. So 1 liter is equals to 1000 ml, as we know that. So 8% means 8 upon 100 multiplied by 1000, that will give you 80 ml. Okay, 2 zeros cancel, 2 zeros cancel, 8 multiplied by 10, 80. Same method we'll follow over here in our next question. So 8% of 2 kg, 1 kg means 1000 grams. Therefore, 2 kg means 1000 multiplied by 2, that is equals to 2000. So 8%, that becomes 8 upon 100 multiplied by 2000, and here's your answer.